So the newspaper have revealed and exposed King Mswati for worse things, and people are thriving. I mean, people are struggling there. People can't afford, and the king is busy splashing money, sleeping with young girls, and specifically virgin, and giving them 100,000 rand. Hey, what a scandal for a king of, look, for a man of his stature, you know, a man who must hold. He's supposed to be a man of integrity, but it's not according to what the news says. Hey, before you start off swishing and you say, hey, Bongs, we're gonna sue you. It's not what I say, it's what these people are saying. No, ET, Swaziland News, said so. Now, there's an article they released on the 16th of June 2024. I will even get you the journalist. By Zweli Martin Dlamini. So if you want to have swishing and what? Zweli Martin Dlamini is the person to sue. Not Bongs. Bongs has done nothing. Bongs is just sharing information that is now public information to his channel that the king himself, you know what I'm saying, Honorable King Mswati III is busy smashing virgins left, right, and center there. You know what I'm saying? It has been said that King Mswati had sex with and sex and gave me 100,000 rand cash after approaching him for scholarship, says Prince Guduza's granddaughter, Sivikelwe Mjongile. This man slept with me and gave me 100,000. So this man is kind of like he's saying, we want help. So you don't have nothing to bring on the table. You're like, yes. He's like, so you're at the table. You're like, come on, you know what you do. You know what I'm saying? Then you'll get what you want after that. Yeah. So people, then their minds go crazy because there's the 100,000 rand probably is too much. Because now, but we can't sympathize with them anyway, because if the man did not rape you, right? So we can't sympathize with you. You agreed to that. But if he had raped you, then we will fully support you without shadow of doubt. You know what I'm saying? We fully support you. So let me go through the story. You will hear that the man is being exposed. Well, this very man that we're talking about before we go into the story is the very same guy that is marrying a 21-year-old Jacob Zuma's daughter. That's the problem that I'm having, because for me, a man of such caliber should be married to a woman of maturity, right? I'm just saying. I'm just an example. Well, before I make this example, guys. There's one thing that I also will wish. I think you guys must make an example by doing this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contributing to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the super thanks button in case you don't want to do that. Guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying, we'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Oh, as I was saying, guys, I'm making an example. So I believe, looking at the majority of Duduzile Zuma Sambondla, if the king wanted to marry a person or a person that will advance, or wanted to marry somebody with an interest of advancing the kingdom of Eswatini, I think a person of Duduzile Zuma Sambondla will make much more sense, in a sense that she's very matured. I'm not saying she should marry her. I'm just saying marrying her will make much more sense because she's very matured. She will bring something to the kingdom. She will change things. But why will you marry a 21-year-old? What is she doing? I mean, if she feels like she wants to party in England, that's the only thing that you will do for her. She's young, and you must understand she's still young.
But that's not where we are. This is where we are. Mbabane, Sivikele Mjongile, the granddaughter of Prince Guduza, has alleged that King Mswati took advantage of her while she was only 17 years and had sex with her as she was desperate to secure scholarship. Sivikele Mjongile, who was born in 2004, is the daughter of the late African National Congress, ANC, Western Cape Provincial Secretary, Sengezo Madiba Mjongile, and Princess Nolwandle Dlamini, the daughter of the Prince Guduza, who is the current chairman of the Eswatini Mineral Board. It is alleged that in 2022, Sivikele Mjongile first approached Mswati protocol officer Prince Baya and asked him to introduce her to the kings whom she knew as brother to her grandfather, Prince Guduza. The first meeting was held at Lutsitsini Palace. Then, bese abantu bathi thina siyathuka uma sithi Mthondo wethu si media production, but nakula Lutsitsini Palace. Thingithule ngingasho lutho. Bese kuthiwa thina sithuka inhlamba. But instead of offering the scholarship as requested, the king allegedly had sex with Sivikele and after finalizing the sexual encounter, presented her with 100,000 rand cash and subsequently kept her as his lipovela.
Oh, so you get smashed and then suddenly you become his wife.
In Swati, Lipovela is a girlfriend to the king who might become the monarch's next wife. This investigative journalist is this investigative journalist is in possession of private picture, including where the cash allegedly presented by the king was placed on top of a sheet inside the room where a certain king allegedly had sex with a granddaughter of his brother. Granddaughter of his brother.
Yo. Things have spiraled out of control here. When you get to the point of you sleeping to people who are your relatives,
But some of the private pictures cannot be released to the public. They were provided to this journalist by a source we trust as backup evidence to substantiate the story. Reached for comment on Monday evening, Sivikele Mjongile confirmed that her family was arranging with the king to have her married by the monarch as the next wife. But Sivikele Mjongile said her intention was not to marry the king, but to ask for scholarship from a relative, King Mswati, who is a brother to his grandfather, Prince Guduza. As a result, Sivikele said she ran away to her boyfriend in South Africa, who is born from Ndebele Monarch. All I can confirm is that I tried on multiple occasions to separate myself from the arrangement that were being made on my behalf by my family. I succeeded in the end by running away to South Africa, where I met Ndebele Royal, who is now my fiance. My God. Ooh-wee. The story is very long. But the story came at the right time, if I may say. Right. The story came at the time where we are talking about
this man, the very same man who wanted to marry this person, gave her 100,000 allegedly. Now is the very same man that wants to marry a 21-year-old person. For me, I'm a 21-year-old guy. That person is not even mature enough. You know, I'm not saying it's not mature, but I'm saying mature enough. Because here you are looking at marrying. For me, when you are marrying, you are bringing a person that is supposed to build the kingdom, right? A person that is supposed to advance the interest of the kingdom. At 21, this person will probably tell you, I want to go have a groove. I want to have a dance with somebody, a princess of some sort, in somewhere in England, somewhere in Europe. And you can't blame her, Shame. She's still young. You can't blame her. I think too long as I'm too a sang tear.